Hello, we're going to be working on acrylic paint on my art journal book in pretty much one hand because I broke my other one, and I'm going to have a production manager helping me and assisting me doing certain details around here. Welcome to the Artsy Second Sunday. Check the information box below for the next person in this beautiful and fun art hub. We love to have you here. And if you're new here, subscribe, like, and let us know where you're from. Now, I need my assistant manager over here. I'm going to tape this. Well, no, I'm not going to tape it myself, but this is going to be taped in here to keep a straight line on this and not to touch this other page. Although later on in another video, most likely I will be painting on it. So that's going to happen right now. Awesome. My painting with acrylic on paper is going to be strawberries. I decided to just go kind of sort of with the actual real colors, which is red, but I'm going to be highlighting with hot pink because this is such a happy color and I need happy right now. And for the background, I'm going to be using a different kind of greens that I will be making myself according to my little wheel that, if you want one, I will have a link for an awesome little gadget like this. It indicates you what colors work best. And if I'm going to be using this red, it's telling me over here that certain types of greens will be working better. And I'm going to go for a dry kind of jade, more or less, green. And another good color would be blue towards the periwinkle. And grape color, which I might try, but maybe, I don't know, depending on how I'm feeling at that moment. Since I don't have the exact type of green that I like, I mixed green with a little blue and then with white to make this type of very light, sagey green. I need my assistant, please, to show it a little closer. This green, which looks a little bit on the grayish side, and I just mirror paint on the camera. Okay, you can put it down now, over here. Thank you so much. So, I'm just going to draw a few big strawberry shapes, kind of like hearts. And I want three, so maybe I'll put this one over here. And no strawberry is the same, so we can make them a little different, like that. And then they have their little thing, and I come back with, I think I want this one a little bigger actually. They have their little stem over here, and the green will be at the very end. So I hope you can see this, and if you don't, take my word for it. Now we're gonna shake the paint and pour it over here. This is one of the very few and limited things I thought I could do by myself, but turns out I can't, so help. Oh, first I'm going to put a paper behind so I don't stain all the other papers on the book, all the other pages. So here we go. I like working with scruggly, scratchy brushes, kind of old, because they tend to leave more paint than what I was planning, and the edges not so precise, because I tend to work super tight, and I'm trying to get away from that. So working with a messed up brush is one of the solutions. Then again, when I go with the green, it's going to also take some of the edges. So let's see how that goes. It's always a surprise. Let me know in the comments if you like leaving the pencil work showing, or if you don't even use pencil, because one of the other ways of painting is just doing your lines with a brush, which is a very good thing. And sometimes I do it, sometimes I don't. But let me know, what way of painting do you prefer? Because it's always interesting to see what others do. Anyway, I'm going to wait for this to dry. With another brush, a little slightly moisted, I'm going to go with the green. I'm going to start in here with the pretty grain that we made, but I like the large brush stroke that a larger brush can give you. The brown stains were another experiment that was good for its time. It was a stain I made with tea and a little bit of paint. I thought it was really cool. Okay, here I am making, I don't think you can see it, but I'm mixing more paint right here. The green, the white, the blue, to make the nice subtle green, which right now is looking kind of bluish, but at the end of the day, I don't mind much. All right, so just keep mixing different types of green with more white or whatever color you like. I'm making such a mess, you cannot even imagine. Anyway, when you have only one hand available at the time, you just kind of sort of do whatever you can and live with it, because sometimes life is like that. And it's always nice to have some variation of paint. Not the chunks though, I don't want this chunk in here. OMG! Okay, now I'm going to let it dry. This ended up way darker than what I wanted, so here I am going another little layer of slightly lighter. Although I wanted a drier green, at this point I'm happy that it's not so formal green. So I'm just going to just do a little bit of an extra layer. I'm happier with this. And okay, for the seeds, while the rest of this dries, I'm going to open some of the brown color and we're going to make some dramatic big seeds. I'm not going to go for little. I'm going to just go and make some big seeds. Maybe even bigger. And wait for this to dry. Instead of using another type of green here, I'm going to use a light turquoise, which is called Patina from Folk Art. It's one of my super ultra favorite colors. I'm just going to make the little leaves in here. Doesn't have to make any sense at all. With a little brown, I'm just going to try make a little line over here just to be able to see more of the little stem. Excuse the fan noise if you can hear anything. It's pretty hot in here, so we need it. I forgot to do the pink highlight first. So what I'm going to be doing in a minute and then fixing it again is the little highlight. And then I probably will have to repaint some of the seeds, but not a problem. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing if you like acrylic painting, art journaling, and more painting tutorials. Okay, what do you think? I still have to fix some of the little seeds, but this is pretty much done. Thanks for watching, and remember to keep your paintbrush wet.